You know what I really love about Islam? I had never thought about Islam in that way before. I am not a revert. I was born Muslim, Alhamdulillah. But I feel like a revert. I have talked about this so many times, I know, but still I want to talk about it again. When I was younger, I wasn't really aware of the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I always thought that, you know, Islam is oppressive, it's restricting, it's like, you know, why should women punish themselves? Why should you hide your beauty? Why should you, you know, why just can't you look attractive for the entire world to see and things like that? And I was doing that, but I didn't get anything in return out of it. There is a beautiful hadith or a saying that I love, that modesty is not about hiding your beauty, but revealing your faith, or revealing your integrity, your intellect, something like that. So when I look at a woman, I see a hijabi girl or woman, for the first thing that strikes me is that she is a Muslim. That's a very beautiful thing. I want to be recognized as a Muslim till I die, hopefully. I love people to know that I am a Muslim woman. And the very fact that someone is wearing hijab doesn't mean that they are perfect, doesn't mean that they are not sinning, doesn't mean that they are to be trusted. But you see, it's a clear demarcation that the person is Muslim, and that most of the time you know kind of what to expect from that person. And I, for example, one of the main biggest advantages of wearing hijab is not getting any unwanted attention. Some women might love to get attention. When I was younger, I also thought that it was flattering when I was getting attention from random men on the streets. I thought that that was a sign that I was, you know, it flattered me, I won't lie. But then beyond that, there is nothing to be gained from that. Like, there can be 100 guys appreciating the beauty of 100 women out there. You're just one of these women, and it has nothing to do with you personally. It's just like they like what they see on the outside, and they are going to make comments or going to stare or whatever they are going to do. So it took me all these years, and you know, I learned it the hard way, that this world, don't be deceived by this world, and don't be deceived by what the majority is doing. I know that it can be super hard when you find yourself in a minority where the majority of people are just doing things which are perhaps contradictory to Islam. And it's fine, these people, you are not going to tell them to what to do or what not to do. They take their own responsibility, and you take your own responsibility. But it's not an excuse for you to not do the right thing. I'm sure if you love yourself and you know how much Allah loves you, and you know that you are going to meet Allah very soon. When I say very soon, it's very soon. Like, we have no idea how soon it can be. You will not care about these people. Why do you care about these people who don't even care about themselves? And for example, yeah, there are so many things actually that I have had. You know what I really appreciate, like every time I keep talking about that, I used to think that, you know, I know it all. I used to think like I was a very opinionated woman. I still am. That's actually how I decided to come back to Islam. I used to think that, you know, I had all the answers to all the questions of humanity. Like, I read a lot of books, it's true. I talk to a lot of people, and I love being free to live my life the way I think is correct for me. And I ended up discovering that actually what I thought about Islam was really false. Like, Allah has no intention of torturing you or making you feel unhappy, but Allah wants to protect you from the evil intentions of the world. He wants to protect you and give you sanity and peace of mind and contentment. Because the world out there is a very harsh jungle, and don't be fooled by what the majority of people are doing, getting all caught up in lust, in greed, in envy, in the, I don't know what it is, the quest for power. But you see, more and more people have no meaning in their lives. They might have a lot of externally, worldly, external things, worldly, material things, but that does not define anything to me, because when you die, you're going to leave every single thing here, and you're going to take your actions with you to the grave, and then it's only going to be you and Allah and no one else.